Shalom. You know, first and foremost, we want to give our praise, glory, honor, joy to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Bahakadash. Double honor to the apostles, the elders, and prophets. And every respect to the real teaching, truth, all over the globe. And the title of this lesson is Israel Need to Repent. And the reason for that is because around the globe, you have seen a lot of judgment and played out here in Israel. And the Most High has jacked his people up because his people refuse to repent. And now you have brothers that don't make lessons on top of lessons about repentance. And it seems as though that our people, you know, even Latino, Native Americans, you're not taking, repentance very serious. And the Most High, Yahweh Shem, Yahweh Shai, he's jacking our people up. Because when a prophet goes out and they speak, and they tell our people to repent, our people don't want to repent. Because in their mind, you know, especially, you know, going to these harder houses, which are so-called these Christian churches, they think they can say a little prayer and a little repentance. They think they just good. You know, they think they're good. And we tell them that they need to repent from, you know, this, and this. You know, according to the scriptures, you know, they get mad and upset. And that's what, you had a lot of Pharisees and Sadducees that did that. And the scripture to back it up is St. Matthew chapter 3. I'm going to go ahead and start at verse 7. Read on up here, you had, talking about John the Baptist. You know, he baptized people in Jordan, so you can read that for yourself to get a better understanding of what the scripture's talking about. Say Matthew chapter 3, verse 7. It reads, When he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees come to his baptism, he said unto them, O generation of vipers, who have warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Bring forth therefore fruits meet for repentance. And think not to say within yourself, we have Abraham to our father. For I say unto you that Yahweh is able to raise up these stones, able of these stones to raise up children unto Abraham. And you know, you had a lot of Pharisees and Sadducees, which, you know, they are our people. They was doing wickedness. You know, they made grievous laws, and they made laws that, you know, that they want you to keep, but a lot of times they don't keep them themselves, man. And, you know, they heard about John baptizing, and John called them generation of vipers. You know, vipers are snakes, you know, sneaky snakes. He said, we have warned you to flee from the wrath to come. He said, therefore fruits meet for repentance. And when it talks about fruits, and I'm talking about literal fruits, it's talking about your works, you know, what you do, you know, to show you how about you, how shy that you repented. And you know, a lot of the Pharisees, Sadducees believe, you know, that they, you know, that they the seed of Abraham, so that they think they will just automatically, you know, they can just automatically get into the kingdom without repentance. And that's not so. And the prophets, you know, try to tell our people that they need to repent. And a lot of our people had this attitude, said, well, I go to church, yeah, I pay my tithe and offer, I confess my sins to Jesus, and I repented already, so I don't have to repent. I can just live my life, I can do what I want to do, you know. All I got to do is say a little prayer, then I'm good. But guess what? It doesn't work like that. You know, we got to show Yahweh Shem HaShah that we have repented. And how can we show Yahweh Shem HaShah that we repented? We show him by our actions. You know, besides, he know our hearts anyway. He know who's going to repent, who's not going to repent. But the message is clear that our people need to repent. HaShah said it, you know, many of the times. One, you know, another scripture is Matthew 4 chapter. you know, starting at the 17th verse, you know, I'm going to start at, I'm going to start at 14 to bring the point. It said that it might be filled, which is spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, the land of Zebulun, the land of Naphtali, by the way of the sea beyond Jordan, Galilee of the Gentiles, the people which sat in darkness saw great light, and to them which sat in the region in the shadow of death, light is sprung up. And that also, you know, that's talking about, the people that, you know, they didn't have the light, they didn't have the Yahweh Shah, and they were sitting in dark, in spiritual darkness, per se. Because our people were going off, man. Our people were going off horribly. Man, they were going off in such a way it didn't make any sense. Because our people, they wanted to serve false gods, and they wanted to do what the other nation did. But, Yahweh was telling our people that they need to repent. He kept sending prophets. They were rising up early. You know, he was sending them to warn our people. But yet our people refused to listen. You know, some of the prophets that they killed and they stoned. You know, if Yahweh would, I'll get that scripture a little later. But continuing on, verse 17, at that time, Yahweh shall begin to preach and to say, repent. For the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Even Yahweh Shah, in the beginning of the ministry, was telling people to repent. You know, he was telling our people to repent. You know, he wasn't talking to these other nations like these wacky tacky Christians. They want you to believe that when you know he was talking to everybody. No, he was talking to the Israelites. He was talking to the Black Latino Native Americans because Yahweh Shah's only dealing with the Israelites. But yeah, brothers, already brought our lessons on there time and time again. But it's no point of beating up a dead horse. But you know what I'm saying? But it's all about repentance. And Yahweh Shah had that constant. That constantly told our people to repent. You know, he said this on, time and time again. He told our people, he said our people to repent. But a lot of times our people don't want to listen to the scriptures, man. You know, they don't want to listen to the prophets. You know, they don't want to listen to what the prophets had to say, because the prophets have been saying, throughout their lessons is to repent. And you see, judgment is gone forth throughout the earth. You know, it's gone forth throughout the earth. And that's plain scripture telling our people to repent. You know, to repent. And why we have to repent? Because we have to repent because we the one that fell off. We the one that broke the first covenant. We the one that turned our back on Yahweh Hashem and Yahweh Shah. Because of our wickedness, because of the sins, what we have done, and the things that we have did. And we the one that put Yahweh Shah upon that cross. Because he had to come down, and not only he had to die for his own sins, for his own sin, he had to die for the sins of Israel. You know, he had to die for our sins, for mainly the hope for that. You know? And that required of him, and therefore we need to repent. You know, we need to repent for what we have been. And a lot of our people, you know what I'm saying, a lot of our people, they refuse to repent. They believe that they ain't done nothing wrong. That's the first thing we tell them in the scriptures, that they have to repent. You know, first thing Jacob said, well, I ain't done nothing wrong. You know, that's the attitude of Jake, man. They don't realize the severity of repentance. You know, they don't realize that, you know, that Jake is getting jacked up. You know, especially look at the Bahamas. You know, our people got jacked up down there. And that was our people. You know, we were Levi, Asher, and they were there was another trial that was down there. 5 people got jacked up. And they got the brother down there in the Bahamas. You know what I'm saying? Probably were teaching and preaching the word unto them, telling them that they need to repent for Yahweh Shem HaShah gonna judge them. You know, a lot of them heard the prophets, you know, and a lot of them probably just went the way they had, or fan their head towards the prophets, said, you don't know what you're talking about. And, you know, they probably laughed off at the prophets and mocked them. And look what happened. You know, Yahweh Shem HaShah, you know, they, you know, he allowed that storm to come in and wipe the majority of our people out, man. You know, now people talking like, you know, they ain't got food and stuff down there. And guess what? You know, it's gonna be a matter of time. Yahweh Shem HaShah gonna do worthless to Babylon the Great. Especially to Jake, because Jake really gonna get jacked up. Jake really gonna get jacked up because Jake don't have no sense of repentance. You know, Jake ain't trying to repent up here in Babylon the Great because they don't believe that this stuff can happen to them. Guess what? The Most High's gonna show our people better than they can tell them. Because our people, you know what I'm saying, especially Judah here in North America, they don't want to repent. You know what I'm saying? You said to come out of the harder house according to Revelation chapter 18, verse 4. Our people don't want to listen. We tell them separate ourselves from the other nations because the other nations are going to get judged. But guess what? Our people don't want to listen to that. You know, they don't want to listen to that because in their mind, they want to cling to these other nations. And the Most High. God's gonna jack them up. You know, he's gonna jack a lot of our people up, especially in Jacob's trouble. Most of our people jacked up. You know, don't you see a lot of the police shootings and all this stuff that's going on with our people? Our people still don't want to hearken, still don't want to repent. And the more you tell our people to repent, it seems like the more our people, you know, they harden their necks against the truth. Well, first and foremost, Yahweh Shem HaShah don't want them anyway. And second of all, they're gonna get jacked up on this side. Because they can't say that they did not get the truth. They can't say that the prophets went on the promise. Prophesied telling them to repent. Because guess what? You know, they heard the truth because Psalm 19, verse 4, it said they sound went throughout all the earth. You know, they're talking about the enemy. So everybody heard of the Hebrew Israelites. Everybody heard of the message of truth. You know, everybody heard of the, I'm talking about people. Our people heard the message of repentance. You know, they heard about it. So they can't say that they ain't heard it. Hear what they have heard about. Heard about the message of repentance that they need to repent. But our people refuse to hearken. That's the reason why they get jacked up. Especially, you know, your favorite celebrities, you know. Your favorite celebrities have been knowing that they were Israelites. And a lot of them ain't gonna repent. And why I said a lot of them are gonna repent because they don't wanna let go of their fiat money. They don't wanna let go of their fame. You know, they don't wanna suffer for the kingdom of heaven's sake. No, they already made that choice. So you had a person on there, you know, on one of the videos, you know, God converted Kevin Gates. You ain't gonna convert that man. You know, that man already made his choice. You know, what about you? You know, have you repented? You know, have you came back to the law that you commanded for y'all about you now? A lot of these chases that get tried to convert these cars, man, they haven't repented. You know, they didn't even put out one scripture to get to Kevin Gates, man. He did not put out a scripture. You know what I'm saying? He was going off. And the Most High is weary. He's tired of our people doing the exact same thing over and over again. You know, all these things were in the scripture. We were written aforetime. We were read for our learning. But yet our people still ain't trying to repent. You know, all the examples that are shown in the Bible. When our people got jacked up from going off, and you figure study the scriptures, get an understanding of what happened to our people when they were going off. And we should repent and turn back to the law, statute, and commandments of Yahweh by Hashem al Shah. But yet our people still don't want to repent. Because I believe it, in the book of John, it said, you know, rough paraphrase, when the tower fell on no 18 people in Siloam, and they asked questions, he said, if the people are wicked above anybody else, he said, 70 people repent, ye shall all likewise perish. And you know, Yahweh told him, he said, if you repent, you know, you will likewise perish. And Yahweh Shema Shah allowed a lot of these stars to get put to death. And guess what? And you got people that you know, they crying and all this stuff over these stars, man. These stars don't care about you, man. These celebrities do not give a shit about you. And you instead you worry about them, worry about what's going on with them, worry about your life, how you repenting. You know, how you turn your life over to Yahweh Shem Al Shah. You know how are you praying that Yahweh Shem Al Shah show you grace and mercy? And are you out there doing the work? Are you doing what Yahweh Shem Al Shah called you to do? You know, the first thing we need to repent, you know, because Yahweh Shem Al Shah command us to repent. Repent of our sin, you know, to repent of the things that we had done against him. Yahweh Shem Al Shah wants us to repent. You know, we have to repent and turn back to the law, statutes, and commandments, turn back to our power. Because all these things in the world, it's going to pass away, it's going to get consumed. But we need to repent, and we pray to Yahweh Shem Al Shah have mercy on us. That's it for the lesson. I pray that you edify. I want to say, call the Lord, Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh, Shah, Bahashem, Rahakadash, double honors to the apostles, elders, and prophets, and the repentant brother, teaching truth all over the globe. See you again with another lesson real soon. Yahweh willing, Shalom, Ababa Baal, and Kwam Yashara.